Widzicie, że było to może wejrzenie. In fact, he's one of the most men I've ever met. He is the world's most best singer, and he can go off the scale of the piano keyboard. You pick him up and send him back, and he's starting. Now he goes down. Freeze. He goes down to a low flat. What is the low flat? So it should be up to Canada. Low flat, okay. Excuse me. Anyway, listen to him this time. I don't want to play. Amen.
Okay, I have the wrong way. Hands on my fingers. She's wrong.
And so this happened, this came up, same way. Except there was a little movie, the Junior Krause. I did a little scene with guitar. He was just a big fat hand. Nothing I could do. They tried to put makeup on him. Nothing. It was just, yeah, it looked like it belonged to another person. But the hand was normal. And here this ham was, except it was worse. It was black. It came out on the album. You look at the album, yeah, listen, and look at the hand. The first player blew it up.
Treat me like a fool.
Yeah.
Smith and Coleman had a very bad affair. Where did that get you?
She said, "Daddy, oh, don't you dare." She had a deep voice.
In the morning, fear went over. Fear! Daddy, won't you
now you listen to my story. Here's the point that I have made. Cats are born to give you fear. Marilyn Anderson,
really paid that much attention to it, to be honest with you. But I found out the story behind why the song was written, and I'd like to share it with you.
This one was beautiful.
Yeah, it's sad. This one was beautiful. Love stories. The story of the man was dying in the hospital, and his wife was sitting by his bedside for 3 days and 3 nights. And somewhere on the third day, between midnight and dawn, she lay down beside him and goes off to sleep. He felt her when she goes off to sleep. At the same time, he felt himself start to die. So he quietly took his notepad from the side of the bed, and he wrote,
think they're fantastic. It's an inspiration. Sweet about it, and I don't know what it is. Thank you. These should be called the crew cuts. Don't do that. I'm kidding. No. We're friends. I'm going to be friends. Geraldine, I'm joking. You're Geraldine. Help me. You see what I want to do?
Booker T.
see him Tuesday. Yeah. Charlie, yeah. She's happy. She's good news. And the Indian boy, see this good boy? He was on the hill there. So, it turns out, on the baritone from Nashville, Tennessee, is a fellow named Ed Hill. Singing the lead, also from Nashville, he's got one of the most powerful voices in the world, Eddie Hinch. And we can just ask him. Doing the high tenor over there is from Nashville, is Bill Bates. Laura does her high voice singing. She was kind of behind us for a year. She's a beautiful voice, and I wish she could have been here tonight. So standing in for her is Kathy Westmore. On the lead guitar, in Shreveport, Louisiana, James Burton. The rhythm guitar from Springfield, Missouri, John Corbison. From down in Dallas, Texas, is Ronnie Tice. A friend of Billy's from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Duke Bardwell. The piano from Lubbock, Texas, is Glenn D. Hart. Probably using my scarves and water and sing harmony with me. What are you doing? That. You know, I mean, I use, what? FDS. No, 5 days over the match. From the gate all around, Chuck Hodge. Thank you. You see the outfit he's wearing? You see that the geek that he's wearing is called? The outfit that the Red is wearing is we had designed, me and a couple other fellows, George, what's George's last name? George Wade, who's a fellow that, no, student. And another guy, the guy that makes my wardrobe, designed his outfit. We're sending a team of the five of the best fighters to Europe to compete against the European fighters, both in Europe and in Belgium. And take an extra guy along in case one gets injured or something, and take in my instructor from Los Angeles as the coach. His name is Ed Parker. I'd like you to meet him. Anyway, I've been in 16 years, and I'd like to do this series.